you. First of all, you have to sort of bifurcate it, because what we do know is the individual insurance market has a lot of problems on the exchanges. And so you have a group of people who we want to make sure have insurance or access to choices in insurance, affordable insurance. And right now, state after state, county after county, we're seeing limited, more and more limited choices. Some counties may have no choice. So if you're in need of treatment and you can't get insurance, you have really no options or very few options. So we're trying to fix that insurance market. This is difficult work to do. It's difficult in the House. It's difficult in the Senate, because we share a common goal of trying to make coverage available, make it affordable. On the other hand, on the Medicaid side, we believe that there's enough headroom in there, in the about $90 billion that's there, that we put in under a provision to allow increased deductibility of health insurance costs. It was really just to move about $90 billion to make it more flexible for the Senate to make some changes. Mm-hmm. We put specifically $15 billion in for addiction treatment and some other related causes, in addition to the flexibility of the Patient, State, and Stability Fund, which gives states great flexibility to use the money either to bolster their insurance markets and or use it for other purposes, which could be addiction. So I think there's a lot there, and it's not always about the money. And remember, early on I said that in my state we're seeing an enormous percentage uptick in people that are 65 and older. Most likely they're on Medicare, not Medicaid. That's a problem area as well that needs help. So, I mean, what we have to do is get to the root cause. You have to get to the prescription issues. You have to get to the treatment issues. I understand, but we think there's room there to do that.